He knew all this imprisonment meant, not to himself alone, not to those shouting men outside. It was the mills. Hark! Fire! Fire! The cry was on every hand. The mills, his mills, were afire. He struggled as never before in his life had he struggled. He struggled till the sweat poured from his temples, till his hands lacerated, till the veins of his neck stood out like straining ropes, till it seemed as though his lungs must burst. He was spurred by a blind fury, but the beam remained immovable. Hark! The maddening cry filled the air. Fire! 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 It was everywhere, driving him, urging him, appealing. It rang in his brain with an exquisite torture. It gleamed at him in flaming letters out of the darkness. His mill! Suddenly a cry broke from him as he realized the futility of his effort. It was literally wrung from him in the agony of his soul. Nor was he aware that he had spoken. God, give me strength! And as the cry went up, he hurled himself upon the beam with the fury of a madman. Was it in answer to his prayer? The beam gave. It moved. It was so little, so slight, but it moved. And now, with every fiber braced, he attacked it in one final effort.